This one is the 5% or 10% paranormal ones that I do. Now, welcome viewers. I have shared in my other paranormal videos things that I have done, seen, and witnessed, but I've never shared this. When I was about 26, so that's 1997, I lived on Palm Island. For those of you who don't know, and I don't know very much about the history about Palm Island, but I'll tell you as much as I do know. Palm Island is to the northeast of Townsville, probably close to off Ingham, and it's used, or it's like a reserve, or that's not a settlement, you know, like in America where you have Native Indians, it's settlement. Well, we have some reservations where we put Aborigines in, and Palm Island happens to be one. I think it was established in the mid-1900s, but as I said, I'm not a historian, so I could be telling you a bit of BS here. But I do know that people who were sent to Palm Island came from all over, like North Queensland, as far away as Charters Towers, and they were sent to live on Palm Island. Off from Palm Island, there is another island called Rattlesnake, and at one stage that was used as a leper colony. Now, when I went over there to live, I was married to a doctor at the time, and I lived on this Aboriginal reservation, and white man can't live on Palm Island unless you actually have a job there, and you have to go to Palm Island, you have to apply to the local council to visit the island. So it's not like a tourist island, it's a very, very beautiful island. But just like any other part of Australia, it comes with its legends and its myths. And I don't know all of them. My two oldest children are actually quarter blood Aboriginal, and they know a lot more because I left my husband and left Palm Island. So I was only on Palm Island for 6 months. But there is one of the legends on Palm Island is called the Devil Dogs. And these Devil Dogs have red eyes, and they're Devil Dogs. They come for you anytime, any place, anywhere. You don't want to be alone with Devil Dogs. And one day, my husband was a doctor, and he was working in the hospital, and we had friends who were teachers. And we walked, probably a couple of blocks to their place, but we decided to take a shortcut, and we went through really, really tall grass taller than me. Next minute, we heard really aggressive barking and growling, and I swore I could see red eyes. This is my two children, because my third one wasn't born. Yes, he was born, but my husband had him, so he was going to bring him later. It was just me and my two oldest were running to visit these friends, and we ran for our lives through this grass because we were being chased by a pack of Devil Dogs. I turned around when we finally got there, and we were really worked up, we were really frightened, and We got to the person's or the people's place, and we said, "Can't you hear? There's, you know, the dogs. They're after us. They're after us." There was nothing there. Absolutely nothing there. Now, there are a lot of Aboriginal, stories of spirits and things, and one of these on Palm Island were the devil dogs, and the devil dogs had red eyes. And one day, I swear to you, I got me and my two children ran for our very lives from red glowing eyed devil dogs. So I thought I would just share that with you. And there's one other thing. This didn't happen to me, happened to my second husband. North of Cooktown is in the north of Queensland. North of Cooktown, there is what's called Black Mountains. Aborigines won't go near them. There is something very sinister, and a lot of people, a lot of cattle has gone missing through time, but that's another story. My story was just sharing with you a little paranormal story, because I've shared with you how I've been abducted by aliens. I've shared with you how I've seen ghosts and things, but Aboriginal, because I'm not Aboriginal, you can't get more English than me. When I did my DNA test, you can't get more English than me. So it's not in my mythology to have devil dogs. And I swear to you that devil dogs are true, because this day we were chased by them. Anyway, thanks for listening to my devil dog story. And if you live in Australia and you know of the devil dogs, I'd love to hear your comment. And just before I finish, these couple that we went to visit had children, and on other occasions after I had actually left Palm Island, my children and these children also had encounters with the devil dogs. So devil dogs are real. And I'm going to later share with you a very funny and interesting paranormal story. I'm just waiting to get my facts straight before I make the mistake and get the wrong country. Okay, thank you very much for watching. Remember, cherish every moment. Every life matters. Love you, and beware of the devil dogs with the red eyes. Bye.